Namaste yogis, welcome. Melissa here from Mystical Stone. Thank you so much for tuning in. So for today's restorative class, we're gonna start on Chair Shavasana. You can have a blanket, only your legs if you like. And let us get comfortable and get ready for some self-care time. You're gonna get your feet through the back of the chair. If you have this kind of chair, move your body so you can really settle your hips and your shoulders. Like you see, I have a blanket on top of my mat. You can do that if you are not on a carpet so that you can cozy up on your mat. Then move your head side to side and just slightly tuck your chin so that you feel that elongation at the back of the neck. Close your eyes and the awareness down to your feet and start relaxing the toes and foot soles. Relax the top of your feet. Relax your ankles. Relax your lower legs. Relax your knees. Relax your thighs. Relax your buttocks. Let your hips and shoulders be heavy. Relax your back, your lower back, mid back, and upper back. Soften your neck, your jaw. Relax your face. And feel the weight of your arms. Relax your hands and fingers. And then start breathing very slowly, very mindfully, all the way to the top of your lungs. Expand and exhale, empty your body, rising as you inhale. Falling as you exhale. Continue to breathe at your own pace. Don't let your mind wander. And when you catch your mind going away, just bring it back and continue to observe your breath. As we start expanding with the breath, you might start noticing some involuntary movements of your toes or your fingers, maybe your eyelid or your lip. Just focus on that area if it's happening and continue to breathe to the top of the lungs and let your body empty. Let us take two more breaths here. And on your next inhalation, wiggle your toes. Move your feet side to side. Wiggle your fingers. Move your hands and stretch your arms to the sides or overhead and give yourself a big stretch. And then release. Bring your knees in towards the chest and fall over your favorite side, feet on the floor. And go into your fetal position. Stay here for a few moments. Use your top hand and on your next exhalation, help yourself up. Coming up onto your seated position, we're gonna take the chair and put it out of the way for now. You can keep your blanket if you have one so that you can make yourself very comfortable. Let us take two more breaths here, full deep breaths. And when you are ready, kind of mindfully bring your arm forward. If your arm is to the top, you circle your arm forward. Relax here and breathe. Use your top hand and help yourself up on your next exhalation. And we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. So without rushing, be mindful as you go onto your back and then lay onto your left side. Get your hip on the floor if you can, and then allow your shoulder to go down onto the floor. Remember that if the bolster is too high, you can roll up a blanket and use that instead of the bolster or pillow. Relax your arms in front of your chest. Make sure that you keep your legs comfortable. If you were crossing your legs, you can do the same thing, or keep them stacked in front of your hips. For your arm position, you can once more stretch your arm overhead for a deeper extension through your side, or you can bring the top of the hand on your lower back, allowing your shoulder to relax back. Make sure this is comfortable. Watch your breath.
We're going to take two more breaths here. And when you're ready, with control, bring your arm in front of your chest, hands together, and observe your breath. Use your top hand. When you're ready, place it on the floor and help yourself up on your next exhalation.
Now from here, we're gonna take the bolster and place it across the mat, along the mat like this. And then rotate your torso. Now have your knees a little bit higher. Rotate your torso and lay over the bolster. Bring your gaze maybe towards the right, or if the neck allows, gaze to the left and breathe. We're going to take two more breaths here. And mindfully turn your nose towards the knees. And we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. So bring your hands under the shoulders on your next inhalation and exhale, push yourself up. Turn onto the other side. Once again, make sure that you move slowly and mindfully. I'm gonna rotate the torso towards the bolster. Have your body as close to the bolster as it works for you. Knees are higher, and then lay over it. Maybe gaze away from the knees. If you can keep your gaze towards the knees, depending what the neck wants. Don't force it, don't torque it. Then relax and breathe.
We're going to take two more breaths here. And on your next inhalation, bring your hands under the shoulders. And exhale, push yourself up. When you're ready, you're going to turn your bolster across the mat. You can have your blankets back there. Keep your blanket handy in case you want to cover yourself once again. I'm going to go towards the back of the mat. Sit back on your heels. Maybe bring your knees apart. And once more, you can make yourself very, very cozy here. So here, you're going to bring your bolster against the knees. Lay over it, so I'll show you here. Probably the blanket is should be coming next. And so you're going to lay over it and then have your blankets in front of you and rest your hands and your forehead down. Relax and observe. And then cover yourself if you like and breathe. On your next inhalation, press your hands, arms down, and exhale, push yourself out slowly. You can put your blankets to the side for now. Move your bolster a little bit higher. And we're gonna sit onto our backs. Have your bolster just a little bit more towards the mid-back. You can have it across the mat, extend your legs, and relax. I like my head supported, so depending if there is no neck concerns, you can relax your head down, but there's no weight here. I definitely like having my head supported so you can have blocks
or blankets stacked under the head. Arms at a T position or a little bit higher in a star pose posture. And relax and breathe. We are going to take one more breath here, full deep breath. When you are ready, bend your knees, bring your foot soles on the floor, knees wide apart, and also your feet, windshield wipe, your knees rolling the weight onto the edges of your feet. Come back to center, walk your feet together, and extend your legs. Draw your navel down, hands behind the neck, tuck your chin onto your chest, and once you are higher here, press your shoulder blades against the bolster, and then bring your elbows down and help yourself up. We're gonna go onto a seated position, so you can sit up on your bolster, you can have blankets or blocks to sit up comfortably. I do like sitting on my bolster, so that's what's gonna happen here, but you do you. Make sure your knees, hips are okay. Okay. So maybe keeping the heat in your body. Relax your shoulders, relax your neck. Close your eyes. Your mind will wander, bring it back. Continue to observe your breath. Your palms are down, so you're grounding yourself. On your next exhalation, tuck your chin onto your chest and move your chin across the collarbone side to side. Come back to center. Gaze forward, shoulders down, hands together at the center of the heart. Inhale with your arms up, gentle back bend, watch for your back and your neck. Exhale back to Namaste. Again, inhale. Inhale, reach back. Exhale back to Namaste. Two more. Relax your shoulders, and when you're ready, find your way onto your back. We're gonna lay down on Shavasana, plain Shavasana. You can have your bolster under your legs if you want. We're gonna find first our corpse pose or Shavasana position, with or without your bolster under your knees. And then you're gonna bring your foot soles together and let your knees flare. You can cover yourself if that's comfortable for you. Relax on your position. Align your pelvis so that your pubic bone and your hip bones are parallel to the floor. Keep your rib cage down. And if you want some extra support, you can have a blanket just so that you can be extra comfortable here.
You can bring your arms at a goal post posture if you want a stretch across the pectoral muscles. This is a gentle chest opener. But if your shoulders don't like that so much, hands by your sides is okay. Return to your breath and don't let your mind wander. On your next inhalation, bring your knees up and exhale, extend your legs forward. You can keep the bolster if you wish. Bring your hands by your hips if they were up. Observe. The next time you inhale, wiggle your toes, wiggle your fingers, move your feet and your hands, and stretch your legs and your arms overhead. Squeeze your buttocks, maybe pick up the hips if your back allows, and squeeze, prune face, tense. Exhale, release. We'll do it again. Stretch your legs, squeeze your bum, pick up the hips, stretch your arms, prune face, and release. And we'll do one more time. Inhale, tense, stretch, tight, tight, tight. Let all tension go. Bend your knees, bring your foot soles on the floor or on your bolster, and then move onto your favorite side. Use your top hand and help yourself up on your next exhalation. And we're gonna close our practice on Sukhasana or easy pose, and you are welcome once again to sit on your props if you like. Bring your hands together at the center of the heart, shoulders back and down. We're gonna seal our practice with our Metta Mantra. May I be happy, may I be healthy, may I be safe, may I live in peace. May you be happy, may you be healthy, may you be safe, may you live in peace. May all be happy, may all be healthy, may all be safe, may all live in peace. Inhale to the top of the lungs. Exhale. Inhale to Om. Tuck your chin onto your chest. Blink your eyes open. Gaze forward. Shower yourself with your own good vibes. And remember to shake off whatever tensions and stresses you don't need. Thank you so much, yogis. Have a wonderful day. Namaste.